Whether you're sold on some good old Costa del Sol,
comfy and tangy,
or maybe you're partial to a bit of Costa Blanca.
I love Benidorm. It's cheap, it's cheerful.
There's one thing us Brits all agree on. Take it away, ladies.
Spanish sun is always fun.
It's why many of us say bye-bye Blighty and hola, sunny Spain.
Viva la España.
Si, si, Karen. Living that life in the sun can come with a cost.
It is difficult when you work together, you live together, you've got kids together.
It can be a tough grind.
We're making it work as best we can.
But when the working day is done...
€244.
You might just make that fantasy a reality.
We love the current bun in Benidorm.
Loving it here. Love every minute of it.
Absolutely love the place.
And that's why there will always be...
Peace and harmony.
Cheap and cheerful.
Very hot, very nice.
Bargain-loving Brits in the sun. Today on the Costas, the cake won't be the only thing in tears as loved-up couple Tanya and Jason head down the aisle.
I know I'm going to get emotional when I see her walk, so...
Feline fanatic aunt is filling up the kitty with cash for these cats.
I picked up about 100 euros off people. I say picked up, I've more or less dragged it out the purses.
And Ding Dong Bell's dreams of going viral could be over before they've even begun.
All my lights gone out.
Oh, I know what's happened. I've shut the computer. Oh, God.
Bargain-loving Brits in the sun. A full English breakfast being eaten.
It's another beautiful start to the day in Benidorm. And everywhere you look...
Cheers, darling.
Cheers, my darling. Love
Cheers.
You.
Love you.
There seem to be loved-up couples.
You.
I love you too.
Jason and Tanya from Dublin are no different and are finally ready to declare their love in the sun.
She's in for a shock when we get there.
Together for 11 years, they're getting married in the Costas.
We have all these for the tables.
But they brought their own decorations with them.
Okay, Louise is not quite aware what we're bringing today.
They're hoping their wedding planner, Louise, won't be fazed by all their extra bits and pieces.
I love a wedding. That's got to come forward a bit.
We have shade umbrellas. We have decoration for centerpieces.
They tried to tie the knot in Spain last year and the year before, but the pandemic put paid to those plans.
3.5 years of wedding planning, yeah.
We're worried about suppliers being moved from one venue to another, but Louise was fantastic. The wedding planner, she's fantastic. She's done everything for us.
You see, we had a lot bought before the venue change, so we just kept them. There was no point in getting rid of them.
With the exception of the table place names.
This is the third time we got them printed, so we didn't put a date on this one.
So third time lucky.
Just in case.
The couple met online, but Jason, known as Jay for short, was a bit more traditional when it came to popping the question.
I proposed to Tanya on Christmas Day in front of her whole family.
Brave man.
Oof. And her sister Caroline and 89-year-old mum Margaret gave their blessing.
She travelled with us to Spain for our wedding. And she's the best in the world.
She's my youngest daughter of seven. I love her to bits, and please God, I love Jay as much, and I couldn't ask for a better son-in-law.
Sounds like you really nailed it with that proposal, Jay. Now the couple just need to hand the goodies over to Louise.
Once this is gone and Louise has these, there's not much we have to do then. Just be ready on the day.
But there's one other thing they have to explain.
We do have a crisp wall. I'm not sure whether you're familiar with a crisp wall.
I'm not, Tanya, but I'm listening.
We brought 120 bags of crisps from Ireland. For everybody
we
else.
We love our crisps.
Everybody took some in their bags. So they'll all be pegged to this crisp wall.
What's the cost of the packet? The crisp wall will be a centrepiece at their wedding because the couple love the snacks almost as much as they love each other.
Off to see Lou with the final bits.
Don't forget the crisps, Jason. And let's hope Louise knows what she's in for.
They approach their car, a dog clambering over a woman on a hammock.
Us Brits are a nation of animal lovers. We'll do anything to help a furry friend in need, come rain or shine.
There's a lot of strays. But the charities do, the animal charities do the best they can
they
for
work
them.
A lot. They work
you know, they
hard
do a
do
lot
that.
Of hours and they work hard for what they do.
I know there's a few rescue centres for animals, whether it's dogs or donkeys. I know one of the entertainers out here runs a sanctuary. And they're always sort of running charity nights.
It's part of our culture of being animal lovers.
Come on, get them off!
When he's not shaking his tush at his aerobics classes, you'll find 38-year-old Ant Pate shaking tins for the animal charities he supports.
Hi, Miriam, nice to meet you. My name's Anthony. We just wanted to come and have a little look round and see if there's anything you need. Oh, look at them, I want them all.
And today, our favourite Skelmersdale lad...
I'm not food.
..is visiting a cat sanctuary in the town of Horradada, where he lives.
Well, we came one morning and we saw that everything had been destroyed.
Ant's just heard that vandals trashed the place. And being the kind-natured soul he is, he wants to help out.
All the cages were open and threw away, and all the food was gone. All the cats were running loose.
When I heard about the destruction of the cat colony, I felt the least I could do was go out and try and raise some funds to help them get back on their feet and be able to continue doing what they've always done and rescue and neuter cats and get them rehomed in the community. I think it's vital.
The cost is more or less, it costs about €500 to restore everything.
I was told a long time ago that you'd only get community with unity. You've got to have that unity there.
As a fitness instructor, Ant's got plenty of people he can turn to for fundraising advice. First stop, it's his weight loss group.
Morning, girls.
I've asked the girls if they had any ideas, and they've come up with a few, haven't you, girls? Elaine come up with the sponsored silence because she never shuts up. You know, Sheila come up with a sponsors eat-a-thon because she loves the food. So, yeah, we've all had just different ideas, and we thought the best one as a group that we can all do would probably be to have the walk.
A sponsored walk it is, then. Ant's asking for a donation to join the charity crew of walkers so they can raise the €500 needed to build new cages and buy food to feed the cats.
Thinking of money, though, girls, there's only one way to start that one. I want your donations. Oh, lovely. Thank you.
There you go.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Oh, lovely.
Looks like a good start there, Ant.
Thanks for getting me going there, girls. That's great.
He wants to recruit at least 20 walkers. And next on his list to get gallivanting for a good cause are his golden girls, Pat and Lady Gaga.
Oh, morning, girls. How are you?
OK.
Oh, it's red hot out there, isn't it? We've come up with the idea of having a sunset stroll. I love the planning. I love the build-up. You can come on the walk. You like your walking, don't you?
Yeah.
Oh, that's lovely. 82 years of age and she wants to come walking.
Getting dressed up.
Are we getting dressed up? I hadn't even thought about that. What do you want to get dressed up as?
Cat ears and a tail. That's what you need. And whiskers. Whiskers.
Some whiskers.
Let's go wild.
Named after the singer for her outrageous fashion sense, who better than Lady Gaga to give costume advice? It is a catwalk after all.
Oh, lovely, girls, but before I go, I need some money off you, please, to give to these cats. Come on. Oh, lovely, you were fast, Pat.
Well,
no flies on you.
That's the start of it.
Thank you, love. Every penny helps. It's appreciated, isn't it?
Ant's made a good start on donations for the Sunset Walk, all for the rescue centre. He's determined to raise €500 to cover the damages. Otherwise, it will be a catastrophe. Coming up... But ex-electrician Des opening a new chippy means it's out of the frying pan and into the fire.
Hold it until it floats.
No pressure.
And watch out, Kim Kardashian. Ding Dong Val might just be about to break the internet.
You do have to move with the times, and the times are definitely going more social media.
Bargain-loving Brits in the sun. A sunny seaside town.
It's another gorgeous morning in Benidorm. And just north from the beaches is Calpe, where 37-year-old Des Smith has set up shop.
Hello.
more specifically, a fish and chip shop. This Irishman only moved to Spain 11 months ago.
Always loved cooking. Last thing I expected to do was come over here and end up owning a fish and chip shop, really.
Former electrician Des recently bought the premises.
The outside of the shop, this took me 2.5 months to construct. The outside, the inside, is total refurb of the whole place. If you want to come inside, I'll show you inside.
Don't mind if we do.
So inside we have the marble tables, the wooden chairs, trying to keep it as old school as possible. We've got stainless steel counters, like back home. In here we've got five fryers, two for chips, we've got one for vegan, we've got one for meat, we've got one for fish. We're trying to create a diverse menu.
Des only opened the chip shop 6 weeks ago, but he wants to chip out his own legacy.
Swiss Fish and Chips is a family-run business.
Des called in a favour from the family.
My nephew, Ben, and his girlfriend, Chloe, flew over from Ireland. Ben had been working for the last 2 or 3 years in restaurants and fish and chip shops and takeaways. And then he has his girlfriend, Chloe. And then I said, I need one more member to get the solid crew together, the team. I met Julie, she was working in a restaurant. I loved her food so much and we got on really well. I found out that she was looking for a job, so she came and started working for me.
50-year-old chef Julie moved to Spain from London 22 years ago.
I don't know if I should say this enough. But
well, go on.
She's got 30 years experience of cooking in the kitchen. She's an asset to the business. She really is.
Well, today, veteran chef Julie will be trying to teach Des how to cook battered fish.
Right, let's get to it.
You best get battering, Des.
We'll see, won't we, about Desmond and putting him in the kitchen. He's assured me he's worked with food before. If he can handle the stress, he'll be fine. And as long as he doesn't get in my way.
Get cracking, you two.
OK, so hold him by his tail. Then take it out. Pull it down on your fingers. Hold it.
All right.
Until it floats, and then let it go.
Perfect.
You're next up, Des.
Come out and you can try to get another one.
No pressure.
Hey, that's my line.
There you go. All right.
Yeah.
It's good to go now, yeah?
Yeah, I'm going now.
Shortly, Des will be cooking in the chip shop.
That's it. And more, come on. Just don't put your fingers in there.
Right.
He's hoping his fish will be the only thing getting battered today. Over in the small city of Albia, it's time for Val Daly to log off.
I'm getting ready for my Ding Dong Daily's Daily Desk, which is live on social media.
That's quite a mouthful, Val.
Morning, everybody. How are we all?
If you've not had the pleasure of Ding Dong Val Daly, she keeps the Costa Blanca supplied with the latest in cosmetics.
Oh, you want 10 as well?
I do.
Yeah, yeah. God, is me thinking I've got a nice tip there.
People call me Ding Dong Val because I work for a certain cosmetic company, very well known.
Val's lived in Spain for 19 years, and for the last few years, she's been one of the top 3 salespeople in her company for the whole of Spain.
Of course, I'm still aiming for that number one spot. I've nearly got there. I'll get there one day.
We have total faith in you, Val.
That's one of them that make your lips grow, you know? The volumizer. It sort of makes your lips go like you've got a bit of Botox, you know?
To try and hit that top spot, Val's having a stab at going viral.
Oh, that's not right. Not doing it right, am I?
Val's about to film herself live on the internet, showing off her new makeup range and hopefully boost her sales.
I'm going to do a live tutorial today of putting on highlighters and contours and things. So that's why I haven't got one. You probably can't tell, actually, because I've got my curly bit hanging down. But I have actually done one side of my face and not the other. Oh, yeah, that side definitely looks better. Definitely.
Oh, you look lovely, Val. Well, half of you anyway. She's hoping her new products will finally get her the title of number one saleswoman in Spain.
So, I've always said a lipstick, if you haven't got any spare money other than a couple of quid, you could treat yourself to a lip and it'll make you feel $1 million.
You do have to move with the times, and the times are definitely going more social media. I'm only one person, so there's a limit to how much I can do by foot, you know, but when I can sit at home and I can speak to hundreds of people at the same time on a live video.
She's desperate to win Saleswoman of the Year.
With July being number one in the country, I was so delighted. So, still a little while to go. I need to keep pushing and pushing.
Val may shine as a saleswoman, but her technical skills can sometimes be a struggle.
The last two videos I've done, while I've been on, it keeps breaking up and it says you're not getting the internet connection. And what I realise is I've had my Wi-Fi on rather than my 4G. I don't want to be cracking up in public.
Not when you're wearing makeup, Val.
Oh, it's the wrong way around. Hang on. I can't find the flipping circle. Is that it? That looks... They've got leaves on it. Hang on.
I think that's your plant, Val.
It's here, isn't it? It's at the bottom. Right, OK. Is this fringe straight? That's better. All my light's gone out. Oh, I know what's happened. I've shut the computer. Oh, God. Right, that's what it is. That's it. Right. Ready to go.
It's a good job none of your customers saw all that, Val.
Oh, hang on, it was taping all that. It was taping all that. Sorry, folks, I didn't realise I'd started. Oh, wow. You started without me. Sorry about that. Welcome, everybody. Sorry.
We've all been there, Val. Time to turn it off and turn it on again and see what you can sell.
On the beach.
Come on, everyone, pucker up.
Been a dorm in the sun.
There you go.
Oh, yes, love is in the air on the Costas.
We've been married 7 years and we've been together 10.
Young love, Rose.
No.
Oh.
Everybody's got one soulmate in life, and that's mine. He's got me and he's stuck with me now. So there you go.
Over in Alicante.
Hiya.
Hi, Louise.
The ever patient Tanya and Jason are finally on schedule for their wedding, which was originally meant to happen in 2020.
I think it's 723 days now.
Yeah, yeah.
723 days.
Yeah. Nobody was counting.
No. I Googled that.
They're meeting wedding planner Louise to check on arrangements.
And you'll have the flowers down the side in the pale pink and the cream.
We have loads of stuff. What now? You might think it's not loads. We think it's absolutely loads.
We had one that was literally this whole shop floor.
Ah, no,
was
no, full. No.
Nowhere near.
Full. No. I mean, on the sofas, on the desks, everything. And I think it took us about 12 trips.
Well, there is one thing she hasn't seen before.
The crisp ball, when that arrives.
Right.
Are you sure now you'll be OK with that?
When you're having dinner, we've got 2 hours in the air conditioning downstairs.
Right, OK,
to take
yeah.
our time and build Grand. That.
Never been asked for a crisp ball before, but Tanya did say that afterwards I can keep the wall and use it for other weddings, so maybe people will see the crisp ball and think, oh, yeah, that's a good idea, I'll have a crisp ball.
Moving on, here's the celebrant.
Hi, Linda. How are you?
Fine, thank you.
Do you want to sit, stand, or a bit of both?
Probably a bit of both would be best.
Linda's checking the ceremony itself will go without a hitch.
And then we've got your love story.
Jay is very kind. He would put everyone before himself. And anybody asks him to do anything, he'd have it done in no time. He's just... You wouldn't have to ask him twice.
What I love about Tanya is her honesty and her passion. She's such a hard-working mother and she looks after her children so well.
Oh, you guys. Linda's final task is to check on those all-important rings.
I will ask whoever's got the rings, I will ask to see them, because I once came unstuck because somebody said they have the rings and when it actually came to
me. No, well, they travelled with me over here. They're not going anywhere else.
With everything sorted with Louise and Linda, the next stop for these lovebirds is the wedding itself.
I can't believe it's happening now.
That's it, yeah. It's real now.
Tanya and Jay leave with Louise.
Coming up, things heat up in the kitchen as Des is at the fryer for his first dinner service.
Hello.
Just all enjoy your food today.
And there looks like there will be two less fish in the sea at Tanya and Jay's beach wedding.
I see everybody out there. I know they can't see me, but I just can't wait until it starts.
I'm really looking forward to it, and it's a beautiful day.
Bargain-loving Brits in the sun.
Hi, welcome to my casa, amore. Would you like to come in?
I don't mind if I do. I'm usually the caravan guy.
So this is my little retail section.
Geordie expat Elaine Lowes practices holistic therapy from this cabin in Benidorm.
It's reflexology, aromatherapy. I do sports injuries, healing. It's where you use energies from yourself. The energy comes through your body and goes through the other person, so it transforms from me to you.
From you to me to Benidorm. Elaine moved here 8 years ago after a lifetime of holidays on the Costa Blanca.
I travelled to Benidorm when I was 16 years old with a family friend, and from that day I said I'm going to live there. And I got sick of being in the rat race, really, working 8 in the morning, 7 in the morning to 10 at night. I'd done that for years and years, and not a really great social life because I was dedicated to work.
And after all that graft, it was time to fulfil her childhood wish.
I had a dream as a little girl, always having a home in a cabin. Yeah, so it's like a fairy tale dream, really.
But although this cabin's definitely for grown-ups, Elaine needs a leg up.
So I have to get the naughty step out to reach the top shelf because it's very tall, or jump on the bench. But really, it's for taller people. This is the living area. That's the hat collection that's going to be put on the wall. Sisters leave hats when they come to visit, so every time they visit, I just bang the hat on the wall.
Fancy hat?
This one. That's got to be my favourite.
Very floppy. On to the bedroom.
And I've got a teddy bear somewhere, which I've had since I was two, but he's disappeared. Where's he gone? He's called Blue, but he's pink. He's got one eye and half an ear. You turn up, he hides all the time.
Not difficult when the owner's barely there.
The house is mainly used in winter. I don't use it in summer at all. Just the bedroom, and sometimes I even sleep out here. I don't tell all the neighbours.
Your secret's safe with us.
The shower room. This is the winter shower, and hot and cold running water. And in the summer, I've got an outdoor shower in the garden, which I've just had made, because before I used to use the hose pipe, so I've gone posh.
She's not kidding.
It's a rain shower. You don't want a jet wash in the garden, do you? A hose pipe. So this is just, it comes lovely down. When you stand under here, you can see the moon. So you have a shower in the moon and set your intentions for the next day. Your mantras.
Your man what?
Intentions for the next day. I set my intentions. Love, peace and harmony, always.
Well, it sounds like Benidorm's living up to that dream, Elaine, and a bargain.
You don't need a lot of money. You can sit on the beach with a picnic. You can get a meal for €5 or a meal for €15 with free drink all night long. That's all night long. So there's just no comparison. For me, it's the best place I could be out in the Mediterranean. I'm healthier and I'm happier.
Keep smiling. See you, Elaine. Look after your chakras.
A large block of apartments with balconies. Val's live streaming.
Down the road from Benidorm in upmarket Albia.
You beat me to it today, folks.
After a few technical issues, Val's online sales shop is up and running.
I'd like to do a bit of a wake-up call, remind everybody I'm here and that I'm waiting for their orders, and that promote a few of the products, some new products I've got to show people.
She's doing a social media promo in her unending quest to be the regional top cosmetic seller.
I'm aiming for number one in August. You know, I was number one in July. I'm aiming for number one in August as well. Everything I've done in my life, I've been the best. I started with the direct selling when I was with another cosmetic company when I was 14.
She's always been a grafter. If she can keep hitting number one every month, she'll finally take the crown of Spain's biggest cosmetic seller of the year. And the live streams are great opportunities to tell her loyal customers about new products and keep those sales coming in.
Now, I've got a couple of things to tell you about that are new products today.
And to help them brush up on their technique...
There you go. Can you see how fine that is?
Val is giving them a personal demonstration.
The one end, you've got a brush, which you can use first to brush if you've got more eyebrows than me. You can brush them up. I've had this face a long while, so I know how to put my makeup on. So it's not really hard. I put makeup on every day. I wouldn't let you all see me without my makeup on. I've got piggy eyes. So that you can actually you get rid of any makeup or anything that's on them already and also put them into shape, ready to use the very fine tip on the other side.
But viral's not the only way Val is helping hit her sales target.
And, of course, we're going for Friday's ladies' lunch today, so we're off there a little bit later on today. I love the social aspect. My ladies are very special to me, and we do have a lot of fun, but it's fun and games and business. I do both. Once I've done all my deliveries and got all my orders in and things, then I can relax.
And now for the finishing touch.
Have a great weekend, everybody. Lots of love. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
A quick check of her own look. She is a walking advert, after all.
Quick squirt. One of my favourite perfumes, that is. I'm just going to check if my all my curly bits are still curly. That's OK.
And it's time to head off to see if she can be just as successful in the flesh as she is online.
OK, I'm ready to go then. See you later.
Val leaves. At Jay's apartment...
Over in La Manga, tolerant Tanya and Jay are about to tie the knot.
I'm a little bit nervous now.
Jay's just hours away from a wedding nearly 3 years in the making.
Just trying to hold the tears back in because I know I'm going to get emotional when I see her walk, so...
Thankfully, he's got the support of his best man, Alton.
He's a good, really, really good close mate.
But it's not your first time doing best man.
It's not my first time, no. It's not my first rodeo.
No.
Which means he's had plenty of practice at the best man's speech.
You mess up, you're in trouble.
Just hopefully just everybody will just laugh, regardless whether it's funny or not.
Meanwhile, bride Tanya is as calm as can be.
I'm not nervous yet. Maybe when I get to the mind, I will be. But I'm actually quite calm, I'm ready. The only thing that's making me nervous is it's going to be millions of people on the beach.
Which is where wedding planner Louise is right now.
If you find Anna and ask where the fresh petals are...
She and her team, including stepmum Irene, are putting the finishing touches to the venue.
Irene.
Yes, miss.
Have you been eating all the sweets?
Yes, miss.
Have you done all your bows? This is where they're having dinner. So, as you can see, we've got a beautiful room with lovely fairy lights.
Oh, lovely, Louise.
Okay.
And obviously, nothing says romance like a wall of crisps.
So, I've never had a crisp wall before, so this is a first. But apparently, I've got lots of bags of crisps to peg to it for the evening party. I'm going to nick some crisps as I build it up, because I've not had nothing to eat today.
I think you've got the monster munchies, Louise. Time to take five and let the team take over.
Yes, just a little mix and mark.
I need,
like, two more.
Yeah.
George.
Hang on, we have a bride.
The bride's here, so make sure nobody comes in here, because I'm going to bring her in here now.
You look beautiful, Tanya, and it's time for her to give Louise her final approval.
We've got your crisps. We've got your wall.
The flowers are lovely, everything is lovely. I'm really delighted. I see everybody out there, I know they can't see me, but I just can't wait until it starts and get, you know, done. Louise has the place absolutely gorgeous.
A success for Louise. And now time for Tanya to meet Jay at the altar. Let's hope their third time's a charm.
I'm really looking forward. It's great to see the turnout that we have, people coming. And it's a beautiful day.
Guests being photographed.
Back at the fish and chip shop in Calpe, during training, Des was taking a bit of a battering from head chef Julie.
1, 2, 3, back in the kitchen.
That we are, Julie, as new chip shop owner Des is about to batter and cook fish for his first ever dinner service.
It's quite funny, though, isn't it, having to show your boss what's up.
Just to get yourself a few more bubbles.
Make sure it's not too thick as well.
Fish coated, fryer on, Des, you're up.
You can keep it still, you don't have to wiggle it around. Lower it in a little bit. And more, one. That's it, and more, one. Just don't put your fingers in there.
Right.
That's it, you can let it go now.
So how do you know when to flip this over now?
When it starts to brown around the edges. That's it. Oh, you've got a nice little crunchy bit on yours, which I'm going to get out of mine. Come on.
So
yours is going to be better than mine.
Beginner's luck.
That's it.
Perfect.
It seems Julie's impressed, Des.
Do we get a certificate now for that?
No,
the Julie's stamp of approval.
No, there's no time for that. It's opening time, and the customers are getting comfortable. But for Des, it might be out of the frying pan and into the fire.
Des waits for a battered fish to cook in a fryer.
It's all a learning curve for me. I'll figure it out.
Well, you better have, Des, as your tables are full and customers hungry. So, with Des at the fryer...
I do this.
It's all hands on deck to get the food out.
Chloe carries meals out to customers as Julie fries baskets of chips. Hurrying back to the counter, Chloe collects more meals, then takes them out front.
With the food served, everyone's getting stuck in. Nice selfie, ladies. The customers seem happy.
It's really good. Very highly recommended.
And they were lovely, and I've had them before.
Well done, Desmond.
Talking of Des...
Hello. Did you all enjoy your food today?
It was beautiful. Oh, it was lovely.
It was
lovely.
Well, there's your stamp of approval, Des.
I'm delighted to be getting hands-on in the kitchen more. And cooking the fish was a fantastic experience, and I will take it up. The whole team today have been stars. They've been absolutely amazing. It's a really good vibe that we have between all of us.
Good luck. Keep chipping away. And as the afternoon turns to evening, Des isn't the only one learning a new skill on the Costas.
I've made the girls some tails. Pin the tail on the pensioner.
In Horadada on the Costa Blanca, mover and shaker Ants making some cat costumes for this evening's charity fundraising walk.
Something to make them some whiskers.
He's hoping to help the local cat colony land on its feet again after being trashed by vandals.
I've picked up about €100 off people. I say picked up, I've more or less dragged it out the purses. €105 in cold hard cash so far.
It's a solid start, and he's feline good.
I should get the rest. I will get the rest. I'm determined. We'll make a difference to them poor cats. I've been quite ingenious with these. They're all different, as you can see. I've tried many different methods.
I'm all ears.
And the good thing is, when we're finished, we can just peel them off and then go back about your business. You might have a bit of glue on it and your ear will get stuck to your ear band, but you two be good now. See you later.
Ant's making a quick detour to a bar down in Horadada for some further fundraising before the big walk.
So we've been on a quest the last couple of weeks raising some money for them. If you do put in anyone that does, thank you so much, OK? I wish you were all right. See you, look at that.
That's topped the cat count up, close to his target at €500. Now it's off to join his own colony of walkers to get dressed up. Nana Pat is up first, as it was her idea.
Oh, there you go. Give it a shake, Nana. There you go.
Shake your tail, Nana.
Anyone wants to meet us? Don't worry, you've got plenty. Who wants a tail? Come on, now, you've got to have a tail.
I'll do your whiskers. I'll have to move your creases out.
Hey, don't be catty, Ant.
60, 61, 62, 63, 64. That's €165 just donated from you lot. Thank you so, so much. When we get to the cat colony, we'll add it all up. Shall we go then, campers? Come on, you lot. Come on, you lot. Slow down, Shane. Isn't this lovely? Look at all these people. A lovely summer's evening. We're out on the Costa Blanca, going for a walk to see the pussies. Everyone's dressed up and happy. What more do you want from life?
Well, it'd be great to hit that fundraising target for the Cat's Aunt. Wow. Coming up! And after two false starts, will today's wedding go without a hitch?
You're my soulmate.
Jay, I love you.
And it's meow or never for Man of Action Ant to reveal how much they raised for the catering.
No!
Dean?
Really?
Yeah!
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Another beautiful day is coming to an end in the Costas, and as people start to wind down, one celebration is just getting started. After nearly 3 years of postponements, Tanya and Jason look like they're finally tying the knot.
Linda.
Welcome, family and friends, to this very special day when Jason and Tanya will make their wedding vows before you.
In La Manga, it's finally happening.
Tanya, I promise to love you with all my heart. You're my soulmate and so much more.
Oh, this is my favourite bit.
Jay, I love you. With all my heart. You're my soulmate. And so much more.
Wedding planner Louise has ensured everything's running smoothly, and Jay's remembered the rings.
With this ring, I do wed.
The Costas have delivered, as ever, with the sun.
It's all that I am. And all that I have.
So just one crucial thing left to seal the deal.
It's my joyful responsibility to officially acknowledge your union as husband and wife. And this is where, Jay, you get to kiss your bride while all your guests give you a round of applause.
Putting an arm around Tanya, Jay kisses her on the beach. Tanya beams, overjoyed. Later...
Absolutely amazing.
What a wonderful day. She looks amazing.
It's more than what we expected. Louise done well, and she really did.
She done an amazing job.
Yeah.
Everyone's happy.
Great to see her happy today, you know.
I was crying the minute they came in.
As soon as the music started.
As soon as I heard that music.
Tears were falling.
When I saw her walking down the aisle, oh, I got goosebumps. I teared up. It was so emotional. It was so good to see.
She's physically actually breathtaking. Like,
absolutely fabulous ceremony, I have to say. It really, really was lovely. It was the first time I've experienced a wedding on a beach. It was really, with the sun, the heat.
And then we go for our meal. We have our first dance here on the beach. And then we're just going to party.
And we'll leave you to it. All the best, Tanya and Jay. And remember, if you get peckish later, there's all them crisps to eat.
Ant and his walkers.
In Mil Palmeras, the Sunset Charity Walk is out in full force.
You okay? How are you doing? Not too fast for you, is it?
Led from the front by on-the-go Ant.
We go nice and slow. No one's in a rush. We live in Spain. It's all mañana, mañana.
This pride of expats may be going at their own pace, but are hoping to raise €500 for a cat sanctuary that has been sadly vandalised.
The community around this area is absolutely fantastic. Everybody looks after everybody.
Even the visitors are helping out. Ant's just met Lynn, whose mum lives here, and she's got some very exciting news.
She went on a sponsored walk with her own friends and they raised... How much did you raise?
€1,050.
€1,050.
In England.
In England, so she's gonna...
I've got that tonight to give over.
It's a huge amount. And Ant's fundraising is going to help the kitties more than he could ever have hoped for.
She's gonna give that to the colony tonight. So this evening, in donations, I think they're gonna get €1,600, something like that. That's triple the target that was set out.
Perfect.
So we're just coming up to the colony now. The ladies are waiting patiently. We're going to go and say hello. We're going to go and see some of the cat. It's just nice to be able to do it.
The walkers are gathered round the sanctuary.
We have some good news for you. We have good news. Come, come.
And he can't wait to tell them.
We've raised for you €1,600.
No.
See?
Really?
Yeah. For you, so you can continue to do your work.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
You're welcome. You're so welcome from all of us.
You deserve it.
The money will make a huge difference, building new homes for the cats, food and equipment. And it's way more than the €500 that they were hoping for.
It's happy tears. Now we have some good fun, yeah? You come and see the cats, come on. Oh, we've got newborn kittens. These kittens are 5 minutes old. She's literally given birth just before we've got here. So we're going to go and say a little hello and then we're going to leave her alone so she can look after the babies. She's had 4 babies. You got your babies? Yeah, you go and look after them? Good. We leave her alone now, yeah?
Seeing the carers at work has reminded everyone just how significant the sunset walk has been.
Get emotional, actually. Yeah, really emotional. Just that people have cared so much, really.
And Ant's tempted to take little Tina the kitten home with him.
I'm your auntie, Ant, yeah. Where's all the old ladies come to see you, look?
You've got to take that home with you now, Anthony. You've got to.
It's too young.
You couldn't leave it.
But a call to his flatmate gives him a dose of reality.
It's not up to me, but you've got the road and you've got the Rottweiler. And you'd have to look after her all the time.
It looks like Tina's staying put for now, but at least the colony's a better place for her.
Thank you to the colony for inviting us over this evening, and thank you to all of you for smashing the target. It's lovely that you've joined me.
Cheers!
Now there's just time for a group photo before they head off for some well-earned cocktails.
See, for Kat. The other way. See, for Kat, yeah? Meow! Thank you, everyone. Let's get you back and go and have our cocktails. Come on. I thought €500 was a big target. And to know that with the culmination of everyone's efforts, we've got over €1,500 is just... It's amazing. I'm completely overwhelmed and so happy that we've managed to achieve it.
And there's a final piece of good news to end the day.
One of the ladies has just come to me and said she's considering taking Tina home. So I said, if you do, we'd assist with help getting her neutered and vaccinations and stuff. I think our Tina's got herself a new home. Cheers for the colony.
Next time on the Costas, metal detecting enthusiast Roderick sets out to save the planet.
That's great stuff. You've saved a seahorse. Well done.
And funny men Frank and Nick go all out to earn some cash.
We've got 80 of them to do, Frank.
And the first number out is tonight's lotto.